Welcome back. This time we're going to see some examples of DNS spoofing. Compared with what Georgia Whiteman does in her class, now I'm bringing this thing to the next level because I'm going to use Social Engineer Toolkit to create a clone of a website we want to use to deceive our victim and grab the credentials they're gonna enter in this website. So I'm not gonna use Yahoo for this purpose here. So I'm gonna enter this page as the URL to clone. And I'm gonna launch Credential Harvester. You see that we need to stop Apache Server, because otherwise Credential Harvester couldn't get started as the port 80 will be already used. Okay, looks like we're good to go. And at this point, we're gonna start our DNS spoofing. But first, if we go to our XP machine and we navigate through the web browser to our Kali virtual machine, you'll notice that we have Yahoo here. Even though there's something off, I have this weird accented vowels. I don't know why that is. It shouldn't be going on. Anyway, I'm going to create now for DNS spoofing a text file called host.txt, where I'm going to store an entry for a login.yahoo.com so it gets redirected to our fake website instead of bringing the victim to the real Yahoo website. And now we're going to use this tool called DNS spoof, and all we need to use is the interface we want to use and this text file we created just now. And you see that the DNS spoofing got started. One thing we need to do is make sure our extraneous traffic gets forwarded, otherwise we're gonna have a denial of service. Then we're gonna run our spoof again in order to poison the ARP cache of the two machines communicating, but this time we need to do that between the router and our Windows XP machine. As a matter of fact, I am forgotten to include the network interface we want to use for this purpose. And the same must be done here in reverse on this different terminal here. Okay. I just made sure we had the right IP address here. You see that we can still connect to our fake website. Anyway, we grab the email address, but we can't get to the password. And anyway, it's not a very credible example. So I'm going to use a different website for this, which is facebook.com. So I'm going to start again this attack from scratch. So let's start over, and I'm going to go through the whole process once again. But this time I'm going to use facebook.com as our cloned website. Credential Harvester is ready. And we can log into Facebook. Of course, I don't have any Facebook account. This is just for show. Just to have you understand the way it works. And you see that we could successfully grab our victim's credentials thanks to the Social Engineer Toolkit. Of course, all this took place without the victim understanding, so that's pretty awesome.